and the Pioneers offense is averaging more than 8 runs per game over their last 3 games played, so they've definitely been hot with the bats as of late.
Yeah, it definitely shows with these 2 hits, but one did go out on the second bat.
And Eaglet's set. Here he comes with the pitch. And that's in there for a strike. Ooh. With an off-speed pitch.
That hit center? We see replay right there. The live stream is back. Hello and welcome to the San Francisco State broadcast. I'm your host, AJ, and I'm here with
Joe Perello.
Today, the San Francisco State Gators are going up against the Cal State East Bay Pioneers.
And the Pioneer, the Gators are 7-1 over their last 8 games to start the season. They're on a 6-game winning streak, and they're yet to be defeated at home.
Currently, there is 1 strike and 1 ball.
And Eaglet's set. Checks back.
Oh.
And the runner dives in back safe.
Why do pitchers do that? What are some explanations on why like pitchers would fake the pass?
Because when the runner's behind them like that, there's oftentimes the ball will go into center field and that runner will get to advance a base. So maybe just to keep him close, not getting too big of a lead,
yeah.
But at the same time, you know, not risk having him go to third on an errant throw.
Yeah. Eaglet with the ball.
And that one's tipped behind the catcher foul. And Eaglet's been a really good start to the year with a 1.54 ERA in 2 appearances.
He's given up 9 home runs? No?
No, that's hits, partner.
Oh, he got hit. So as a hitter... I know, though, as a hitter, you don't want your pitchers, like, at bat. Why is that a lot? You know, a lot of times in, like, pros when pitchers are just only pitch and they don't hit?
Yeah, see, it's the same here, you know, because it's really just so they can focus on their craft. And because, you know, if you think about it, you know, the batters don't have to worry about the pitching, so they're at an advantage already. So it's better to just kind of stick to your specialty. And that one's aligned past the second baseman.
That's number 5, A.J. Schrouder.
And Brown takes a wide turn around third, but holds up.
AJ Schrouder was ever able to make it a second base. That was a good hit. No. Sorry about that, guys. That's Luke Brown. Or
at batting number 8, Luke Brown.
At bat right now is Luke Brown.
And Brown has a .286 average on the year. He started all 10 games.
That's reliable. Ooh. Is that a ball? I didn't see that.
Eaglet set for the pitch. And that one a little high.
That is crazy. The margin for error for those throws is very small. Like, and at the speed they're throwing at, too?
Yeah, partner. At the last game we covered, the home plate umpire was definitely calling those pitches strikes. So it just goes to show you, you know, different umpire, different strike zone. And that one's fouled off.
He's about to hit him.
And Eaglet gets ready to deal. Ooh. And that one's fouled off again. Brown's battling here at the plate.
That's a 2-2, right? It's two balls, two strikes.
And with two strikes, Eaglet looking to get the strikeout here. Try to keep those runners where they are on the bases.
Ooh.
That one fouled off again. And Eaglet was the Gators' 2022 Team Golden Gator. Currently sits at 6th in the rankings of strikeouts all time for San Francisco State. And that one's hit. The second baseman gets it on a hop, throws over to first, and he's out. But the Pioneers do get one run.
Who was that at the – who was able to get the run? Number 7?
Yes, that was the leadoff man, Brown, there, scoring his team-leading 15th run of the season for the Pioneers.
Now at bat, number 19, Matthew Ohomoni. Ohomoni? He's also played in 10 of the 10 games as well. They have a lot of players that have played. They've had 4 players that play all 10 games.
And Eaglet trying to keep the damage limited here. That one's in for a strike. And Eaglet's quite the towering presence on the mound at 6'4", 220 pounds.
He's a junior. Third year here.
Ooh. And that one's fouled off. Deep into right field. Eagling gets set, waiting for the sign, shakes him off, and he gets set. Here he comes with the pitch, and that one's high and tight. And Eaglet sits him down there.
That's 3 outs. So now they switch. Now it's the bottom of the first, right?
Yes, indeed, partner. And a little between innings, Sweet Caroline to serenade us. Yes, and the Gators actually all-time now record against the Pioneers, interestingly, sits at exactly 25-25. So the winner of this game will take the all-time lead in wins for the two competitors.
They will definitely have the upper hand in that.
And the Pioneers come into San Francisco having won 3 of their last 4 games, so they've been playing pretty well here. Also scoring 8 runs per game in their last 3, so the bats have been really hot. The last time these teams met was way back in March of last year, and the Gators lost that game 13-2, so hopefully get a little revenge here today.
Mm-hmm. It's crazy. They're 7-1. Their last loss was February 11th. Against Colorado Springs.
Yeah, only the second game of the season, and since then the Gators have had an untarnished record. And Sammy Gonzalez is going to be leading off the bottom of the inning here for the Gators. So far this year, he's been struggling a little bit at the plate with a 208 average, but he's going to see if he can not lead things off right for the Gators here.
Sammy Gonzalez is at bat. He's a redshirt junior from Winters, California, and he had formerly played in Butt College. Butte College, sorry about that.
Yeah, and Sammy has the very unique goal of opening his own fireworks shop post-college. In 2022, Sammy was the Gators' team player of the year and started all 46 games he played in for the Gators last year. Very reliable for San Francisco State.
Ooh.
And that one's high into left center. Yeah. Left fielder is under it, and he hauls it in.
Great catch. Great
catch. And
that's
one out for the Gators.
Now at bat number 26, Daniel Santos.
And Santos comes in with a 333 average. He's been swinging the bat pretty well here. Santos lays off that one high. And that one's into foul territory. And it falls in foul. And last game, Santos had a double for the Gators.
Pretty good. At bat is number 34.
And that one's up. Pioneer second baseman underneath it. And he gets it for the second out of the inning. Coming up to the bat for the Gators, Nick Upstill.
Number 23, Nick Upstill.
Pitching for the Pioneers is Ethan Broski, a junior from Michigan Valley.
And Upstill waits for the pitch. And he lines it between the shortstop and the third baseman for the Gators' first hit of the game.
That was a great hit by number 23, Nick Upstill.
And here comes Justin Clark for the Gators, batting in the cleanup spot.
Jackson Clark, a senior from Pleasanton, California.
Yeah, and Clark's been really hot at the plate recently with a 467 average.
In 2022, he played in 31 games and started for 26 of them as a designated hitter. Ooh.
And Pioneers pitcher Ethan Brodsky gets set. And that one's in the dirt low.
Another ball.
And Brodsky delivers. That one's in there for a strike. So far this year, Brodsky has a 3.37 ERA, one win, one loss in two appearances, and 10.2 innings pitched. And he deals again. And that one's in there for a strike looking again. And Clark will be protecting the plate here with two strikes.
Ooh. That was another strike. That's
and
out.
And Brodsky thought he had that one, strike three, started to walk off the mound, but umpire said no. Clark's walking to first, base on balls.
Now coming to the mound, number 20, Cody Gardner, senior from Sacramento, California. Sacramento City College.
Yeah, Gardner's been really leading the Gators this year offensively. He's leading the team in home runs, doubles, hits, at-bats, runs, and RBIs. He's also the only Gators player to start in every game so far this year.
That's amazing. Ooh.
And starts him off with an off-speed pitch. That one's in there for a strike looking to Gardner.
Cody Gardner was named Gator of the Week February 6th through the 12th. Pretty recently, too.
Yeah, he was the first Gator to win that honor in years, partner.
Wow. Ooh, low pitch. Ball?
That one is indeed low for a ball. And Gardner had a double and an RBI in the Gators' last game. Brodsky gets ready to deliver.
Ooh.
Off speed pits. Gets him ahead there.
Two, one count. Ooh, swing and a miss. Oh, wait.
And that one's in that one, and he strikes him out, but it was in the dirt. The catcher thought that the catcher did not know he was he had to still throw it to first base. Gardner is safe at first. The Gators now have the bases loaded with two outs.
Now for a non-sport, not for a non-baseball player or a person to know baseball, explain that for me.
Yeah, see, so what happened there, partner, was, you know, on a third strike call, if the ball hits the dirt, the catcher either needs to tag the batter or throw the ball to first before he gets there. And I think what happened there was the catcher might have thought he got the ball cleanly, but the umpire thought it hit the dirt. So the catcher started to walk off the field with the ball. And by the time he threw it to first, it was too late.
Yeah. Now I'm out at the – ooh, a high pitch. At the mound is number 7, Gavin Hermitez from Santa Barbara.
Now, and Brodsky's now – that's the last two batters that Brodsky's now thought he struck out. So might be amped up a little bit here with that first pitch a little hard and high.
So that's an error by the catcher, correct?
Yes, technically.
Ooh.
And that one's into the outfield. Oh, and it falls in. And that's two runs for the Gators. They take the lead here in the bottom of the first.
Number 7, Gavin Hermenta, was able to hit it and take it to first and what, get the next hitter, the next person into second base?
Yeah, Gavin Hyvenmitz with a two RBI single there.
Wow. Now at the mound, number 5, AJ Schrader from San Diego.
That one's fouled off there by Schrader.
AJ Schrader is a junior and who was also named the CAA Spring Academic Honor Roll, who played 42 games and with 37 starts.
He had a run batted in last game for the Gators. And lifts that one very high in the air into the outfield. And the right fielder hauls it in.
And that's number 3.
Well, we're heading to the second inning here. Gators quickly getting on the board for a 2-1 lead.
What do you think of this game so far, partner?
Well, you know, it's interesting. It's interesting to me, partner, because both pitchers have been pitching really well so far this season, but it looks like both of them are having some struggles here early on.
Mm-hmm. What are some of the struggles for SF State? What are they having?
Pitching wise, I think early there, Eaglet was coming right after him, and the Pioneers were ready. You know, they were any pitches that were in the strike zone, they were right on top of him and making solid contact. But seemed like he started to move the ball around a little bit later on in the inning there, and was able to hold him to just one run. So see maybe if he's back into a groove here a little bit.
And what have the Pioneers been doing to keep it steady, I guess, or you know, stay in the game?
Well, I think, offensively, as I said, you know, the Pioneers just started out very aggressive at the plate and weren't waiting around.
Yeah. Now batting for the Pioneers, number 3, Cole Anderson.
And Anderson has a .235 average on the year so far. And Eaglet delivers. That one's in there for a strike right at the belt. And Anderson backs up. That one's inside for ball one. 1-1 count.
Ooh.
That one's lined into left field by Anderson. He rounds first, and he'll stay there for a single.
Now batting the designated hitter, number 10, Jacob Clemency.
Now to the mound, number 10, Jacob Kaliski, a sophomore from Claremont High School.
And Klonofsky unable to reach base so far in 6 at-bats.
Let's see if he can get that today.
Hits that one high and deep. Center fielder going back at the track. Makes the catch.
What a catch. He was backpedaling, and he almost hit the back of the wall and still was able to make that catch. Great concentration by the Gators.
Yeah, I agree, partner.
Now batting the catcher, number 15, Jacob Brace.
For the Cal State Pioneers, at bat, number 15.
And that was Sammy Jacob. Gonzalez tracking that ball down there in center field. Great catch. Keeping the trouble limited so far for Eaglet here in the second. And Eaglet checks on the runner at first, back safely. And Eaglet delivers. That one's in there for a strike, looking to Frost. Frost only one hit on the year and 13 at bats, so see if Eaglet can limit the damage here. With the number 9 hitter on deck for the Pioneers, Eaglet's going to try to get out of this inning without letting the top of the order come back up.
And you called it right there. You tried to get him out there.
Yeah, Eaglet's keeping an eye over there on first, making sure he doesn't get any ideas about stealing. And that one was close, but called the ball.
Low pitch. From this angle, it looked like it was down the middle, but
you'll never know what the umpire sees. And Eaglet gets set. Delivers. Ooh, and that one hits him. He's on his way to first.
Now, what type of pitch was he trying to throw there?
Yeah, it looked like that was an off-speed pitch there from Eaglet that just got away from him. And Frost there, who got hit by the pitch for the Pioneers, that's now the fourth time he's been hit by a pitch.
Now I bet for Pioneers, number 14, Samuel Impreza from Laney College.
And Esperanza takes that one for a strike. Eaglet shook off that hit by pitch there, came back to get one in the strike zone. Runners on first and second here for the Pioneers. Eaglet from the stretch.
Runner on second looks very... Oh. Did the ref just give a violation? With the time?
Yes, that was a... and that time, Eaglet went over the pitch clock there.
Ah. So is that a warning?
Yes, that's indeed a warning.
And after you get that call again, what happens?
I think they will let the runners advance, oh. if I'm not mistaken. And, that's a very close play on the check from Eaglet at second, but he barely gets back in time.
That looked very close. Let's see if Samuel can get a hit.
And that one in the dirt. Oh, and the runners advance for the Pioneers. Getting away from catcher Matt Sugden there. It's a tough one for him to corral, though. Hard pitch in the dirt. Mm-hmm. It's now two runners in scoring position for the Pioneers. Eaglet going to bear down here. Runners take their leads. Eaglet delivers and... Very half-hearted swing by the Pioneers player there. He was fooled on that pitch.
It looked like it was a hiccup. It looked like he wanted to take it back, like he wanted to pull the string on it.
Yep. Halfway through, he said it, his arms were already going. And Eaglet from the stretch again. Here it comes. Oh, that one's out in front of home plate. Sugden takes it, gives it to first. That's two outs, but the Pioneers do tie the game on that. And an RBI for Esperanza. That's his fifth RBI on the year for the Pioneers. Coming up now, back to the top of the order for the Pioneers with Essex Brown Jr. Got on base with a single in the first.
They have a runner at third. Ooh, strike.
And that one's in there for a strike from Eaglet.
Ooh, pitcher misses it.
And that one's hit hard to the second baseman, but he gets it and corrals it for the third out of the inning. And we're moving to the bottom of the second now. And Matt Sugden's going to be leading it off here for the Gators in the bottom half of the second inning. Right now, Sugden's 667 average leads the team for San Francisco State. With 8 hits and 12 at-bats, Sugden's really, really been hot.
How do you like the pitching from the SF State Gators in that inning?
You know, it seems like Eaglet's, you know, just having a little bit of trouble, but it seems like he's minimizing the damage.
Right.
You know, there was multiple base runners in both innings, but Pioneers have only been able to get two across, still have a tie game. So I think for all things considered, they've been starting out pretty much about as we expected. You know, again, the Pioneers averaging 8 runs over their last 3 games, so their offense has been hot. Yeah, just about by the book, I'd say so far, partner.
Now at bat for the Gators, number 9, Matt Sugden. Pitching for the Pioneers is number 34. Pitching for the is Ethan Brodsky.
And Brodsky gets ready, delivers. That one's way high. And interestingly, Brodsky pitches from the stretch the whole game. He does not go into the windup at any point, even with nobody on base to start off the bottom of the second here. He's in the stretch. Here it comes. And that one's hit high and deep to left field, over the left fielder's head. Sugden rounds first, headed into second, and he's in there safely with a double to start off the second inning.
Great double to start off that inning. That went, it was a straight line drive over the outfielder's head.
Yeah, right over the left fielder's head. He had a good read on it, but just wasn't able to get it. That one went all the way to the fence for Sugden. Great way to start off the inning. And that's overthrown. Here comes Sugden home, and he's safe. Gators take a 3-2 lead.
Chance was able to get a double out of that error from the pitcher.
Yeah, Chance advances on the errant throw there. And a lot of action early on here in this one, partner.
Definitely, definitely. Very exciting for the Gators with that run in. Now just Gators take the lead.
And the team very excited in there in the dugout.
At bat for the Gators, number 10. Sammy Gonzalez.
Another bunt here.
Let's see.
And he's out at first, but the runner does advance. Now the Gators have a runner on third base with only one out here in the second inning.
That definitely gives them an advantage, and it looks like they were going to score with that momentum.
Yeah, and only in the second inning. We've already had two ties and two lead changes. Pretty incredible.
Yeah, and just in the last game, how many hits did we have? Yeah. A total of 9?
Yeah, no. There was like, I think the last game that we covered as per BECA was about, I think they had 5 hits combined in that game. So, yeah, there's definitely a lot more action here today. And that one gets through the middle. That was the fourth run home for the Gators.
That was number 26, Daniel Santos, sophomore. Great hit to go to first base.
And that's another RBI for Santos, who also drove in a run last game.
Now going to the bat, number 23, Nick Upstill. He's a sophomore from Huntington Beach High School.
Yeah, I'm still second on the Gators in RBIs with 8.
And another hit.
Another line drive over between the first and second baseman. Runner advances to second. Little errant throw on the cutoff there, but runners stay put.
That's Upstill, another RBI, huh?
Single there. No RBI. No? Single there for Upstill. The runner does advance, though.
Mm-hmm.
Now we got still a 4-3 score here. A lot of action going on.
At bat for the Gators, number 2, Justin Clark.
And Clark tips that one foul behind the catcher. Runner on first and second here. Brodsky getting into a little trouble in the bottom of the second. And it's not going to get any easier with Gardner on deck for the Gators.
Pitcher throws it back to second, checks the runner.
Come on,
What?
And that one's low for Clark. And here he comes with the pitch. That one's fouled off.
Justin Clark played in 31 games and started for 26 of them as a started at a right field and a designated hitter.
And Brodsky trying to work through some trouble here. Justin Clark at the plate waits. And that one's a little low and outside. And that one's fouled off hard into right field by Clark. Still at two strikes here. Gators with five hits already here in the second inning as the score sits at 4-2. Pioneers already two errors. Ooh, and that one gets Clark right in the knee. That one's gotta hurt. He goes down as the team comes out to check on him.
Oh,
and he's all right. He shakes it off as he jogs to first. His teammates cheer him on.
Now at bat for the Gators, number 20, Cody Gardner.
And this is just the guy the Gators want at the plate here with the bases loaded. Try to really break the game open here in the second inning. Gardner can perhaps put one in the gap or even maybe over the fence as his three home runs lead the Gators. Oh, and that one's off speed. Gets on top of it a little there. Get the force at home plate. Gardner safe at first. Bases remain loaded. And here comes Gavin Heimovitz to the plate. Heimovitz with a key hit his last time at bat. See if he can do it again here. Two outs.
See, the catcher at the end there, he pump faked and didn't throw it to first base, not trying to get him out. Why do you think is that? Why?
Probably the risk reward. You know, there's probably was going to be safe anyways, so mm-hmm. Don't risk throwing it, having him advance or having a run score on a long throw.
Or maybe even an error, too?
Yeah. And Brodsky waits to deliver. Here he comes with the pitch. And Heimovitz hits it hard on the ground, and that one's through. One run's in. Second run. Stops at third and keeps going and dives in safe at home plate.
Heck.
That's another two runs for the Gators. Scores at 6-2 now, and the line keeps on moving. Heimovitz, his second big hit of the day.
Was able to get two people in the home. And got it looked like number two, Justin Clark, stopped halfway and was able to still come back and get the home.
Yeah, he hesitated there. If I saw correctly, I think it was also the third base coach. You know, he stopped him, and then I think maybe out of our view, the outfielder there might have bobbled it a little bit, which caused him to end up sending him home. But he did make it by a hair there, diving into home.
Great hit. At bat for the Gators, number 5, A.J. Schroeder.
And that one's low to Schrader, 1-0. A Runners on first and second here for Schrader. Brodsky from the stretch. Here it comes. And swing and a miss from Schrader. That one a little low.
We're getting a lot of things. We're getting a mix of everything in this game. We're getting hits. We're getting outs. We're getting a little bit of everything. It's good and entertaining.
Yeah, a lot of this game's not lacking variety so far, partner. And Heimovitz lays off that one in the dirt, gets by the catcher, and both runners advance for the Gators. Two runners in scoring position now for Schrader. See if he can just squeeze one through into the outfield and get another two for San Francisco State here. And Schrader takes that one for a strike. And Schrader will be protecting here with two strikes. And that one's lofted in the infield, and the shortstop corrals it with a basket catch to end the inning. And we head to the third. The Gators get out there, but take a 6-2 lead into the next inning.
Manny Garcia.
Garcia takes that one in for a strike. There's a 250 average going right now on the year. And Eaglet winds up, delivers. That one a little high there. And that one a little low there to Garcia from Eaglet. 2-1 count. And swing and a miss from Garcia. Two balls, two strikes.
See if Eaglet can finish this. Nods him
and
off and accepts the second one.
And
high ball.
Yeah, might have reared back a little too far there. And here he comes set with the full count. Garcia takes it, and that one just missed for ball four as he heads to first base to lead off the inning for the Pioneers.
Now batting, third baseman, number 5, Luke Novitski.
in the third baseman, Luke Nowitzki's coming up here now for the Pioneers.
Sophomore out of Pleasanton, Foothill High School.
And Niglet checks on Garcia at first and dives back in safely. And at the plate here, Nowitzki is actually leading the Pioneers in RBIs this season with 9. See if Eaglet can keep him off the bags here. And that one's called a strike by the umpire. Runner at first takes his lead. Eaglet delivers.
Ooh.
And that one's a strike.
Great pitch by Eaglet.
Yeah, two straight strikes taken from the Pioneers batter there. And, you know, one right at the knees, one right at the belt. Eaglet really doing a good job changing up the depth there.
Eaglet checks at first base, but the runner is safe.
And that one's grounded and bobbled by the Gator second baseman.
He called that safe. Umpire was able to call that save from this angle. I know you didn't see that, but he did. He did give off the save.
Yeah, partner, I was blocked on that one. After watching the replay there, I do see that, yeah, it seemed like the runner just beat that ball to first base. So, unfortunately for the Gators, that's the first two batters of the inning on base.
At
see
bat.
If Eaglet can work out of a jam here.
Yeah, at bat for the Pioneers, Luke Brown, outfielder.
Yes, the second Luke in a row here for the Pioneers in the order. They have back-to-back Lukes and back-to-back Jacobs in the batting order.
Seems to be a common name over there in Cal State Bay.
Apparently. Maybe they put them next to each other in the lineup to confuse the opposing coaches there. And Luke Brown fouls that one off behind the catcher. And as we said earlier, Brown's been really hot for the Pioneers, leading the team in average at 353. Also leads the team in hits with 12, doubles with 2. And Brown takes that one for a ball. Looked to be a pretty good pitch, but umpire calls it a ball anyways.
Luke Brown's batting average is a 229 and with 65 at bat.
And that one's hit into the outfield by Brown. Runners hold. The runner holds at third, but the Pioneers do get one on that.
I missed that. Was that a catch out by an outfielder?
Yeah, see, I was blocked on that one too, partner. I actually think the Gators did manage to get an out there.
Pitcher checks at first base, but runner is safe. Coach making some calls. And checks again at first base.
Eaglet gets ready with the pitch, delivers. That one's fouled off behind the stands. Let's get the Eaglet gets ready, throws back to first again. Eaglet's really making sure those runners don't get big leads today.
Seems like they don't want to score. They don't want to allow any points no more and just keep this lead.
Yes, sir. And that one's in there for a strike from Eaglet.
That's the second strike. Let's see if he can get his third.
That one a little high there from Eaglet.
It's such a tough judgment to see how, like, for in real life too, to see that how, I, like, if it's a ball or strike.
Yeah, it
just
is.
Just there, I thought it was a ball but or a strike, but nope.
Yeah, that one a little high there. That one's lined into left field by the Pioneers batter. Runner advances to second. Now runners on first and second here for the Pioneers.
That was Matthew.
Left fielder number three, Cole Anderson.
Batting for Pioneers, number three, Cole Anderson.
That's two outs here in the inning. See if Eaglet can get out of trouble here. Already limited the damage with help from his fielders.
Swing and a miss.
And Cole Anderson with a big swing on that one comes up empty. Eaglet looks at the runner, delivers. That one's in there for a strike.
Great pitch by Eaglet.
That one's high and deep to center field. Gonzalez under it, and he hauls it in for the third out of the inning. We go to the bottom of the third. Gators up 6-2.
Great energy by the Gators, looking to have a hot start to the game. What do you want to see more out of them in the rest of these innings?
I think they can keep doing what they're doing with a 6-2 lead. It seems like they seem to have themselves going in the right direction as of right now. Eaglet's seems like he's been getting stronger as the game's been going on, and that actually was the case last Friday as well when the Gators took on CSU Pueblo. He continued to gain strength as the game went on. It seemed he ended up going 7 innings in that game, which was his high for the year.
Interesting.
And see if he can match that today.
And what do you see? What do you think? Why are the Cal State East Bay Pioneers struggling?
I think they've had a few blunders in the field, a couple early errors. That definitely doesn't help them. You know, 2 errors in the first 2 innings. That's not a recipe for success. And
it could kill their morale too.
Yeah,
early on.
And on the offensive side, they've made a few mistakes on the base paths, and you know the Gators defense has also been coming up big when it matters. So they've really limited them as much as they can. You know, last inning they had the leadoff runners on first and second, but you know the Gators were able to get out of the inning without giving up any runs. So it's been managing the damage for the Gators has been the key so far to me.
That's definitely the case. Now I bat for the Gators. Number 9, Matt Sugden. Matt Sugden out of Foothill High School. He played, he transferred from Chabot College his freshman year. And was named MVP and the player of the week during some of the tournaments they played. Ooh.
Sugden takes that one for a strike. Gators catcher has been busy behind the plate today, stopping a few balls in the dirt. See if he can get busy at the plate here. And he tips that one down the line. Foul. And after running that one down at first base, Sugden back in the box, ready to battle with two strikes. Brodsky gets ready to deliver. Here comes the pitch. And that's a swing and a miss. Strike three for Sugden.
Now batting the shortstop, number six, Kayla Chin.
Back at bat for the Gators, number six, Caleb Chance. Caleb Chance is a sophomore out of De La Salle High School.
You'll see if Chance can get on base here for the top of the order, San Francisco State. And he lines that one up the middle, stopped by the Pioneer shortstop, and thrown to first base for the out. It's two outs in the inning for the Gators. And here comes the top of the order with Sammy Gonzalez coming up to plate. Gonzalez takes that one for a strike right at the knees.
Number 10, Sammy Gonzalez, is a redshirt junior from Winters High School.
Sammy hits that one down the line, thrown over to the pitcher on the ground out for out number three.
That's the end of that inning.
Yes, we head to the top of the fourth here with the Pioneers coming up down 6-2.
You can definitely there, the Pioneers defense definitely clamped up, played a little bit better, not allowing any runs.
Yeah, they were clean in the field that inning. You know, Gators not as hard of contact there, but they were still able to, you know, clean it up in a relatively quick fashion there. And Eaglet takes the mound for his fourth inning.
When do you see pitchers get switched out? You know, when is a common time for that to happen?
You know, it depends on the stamina of the pitcher, and it depends on how they're doing in the game. Yeah, it's actually, like, really random. I would say on average, probably the starting pitchers in college get taken out probably around the fifth inning, sixth inning, about there. But, you know, if they're having a rough day, they could get taken out in the second or third. And if they're having a really good day, they, you know, might last until the eighth or even the whole game if they can keep their pitch count low enough.
Yeah. Now at bat for the Pioneers, number 10, Jacob Kalinski. Swing.
And that one's foul out of play from Klonowski, 0-1. And strike two quickly.
Jacob Kalitsky is a sophomore out of Claremont High School. Appeared in 35 games and started 28 of them with 20 hits, 3 doubles, 1 triple, and 15 RBIs.
And 1-2 here to Klonofsky from Eaglet. That one's in the dirt, swung on and missed, and Sugden throws it down to first for the first out of the inning. Good way to start out the inning there for Eaglet. That's what he wanted.
Now batting the catcher, number 15, Jacob Grace.
Batting for Pioneers, number 15, the catcher, Jacob Fress.
Eaglet delivers.
That one's high.
Heads. Ooh, shh.
And that one lands right by me and my partner.
That was a close one. We almost had to abandon ship.
Yeah, sorry about that, fans. We couldn't give you the play-by-play because we were worried about our own play-by-play over here.
Was that a ball? Yes, very low.
And Eaglet from the windup rears back. That one low and fouled off there.
Currently is one out and one ball. See what we can do.
And a check swing there, lofted to the Gator second baseman for the second out of the inning.
Yeah, A.J. Schrader with the Schrader with the catch. Now that's two outs.
It is indeed two outs, partner.
Number 14, Samuel Esparza.
Number 14, Samuel Esparza is at bat.
And Esparza, not your typical nine-hole hitter. 300 average on the year and 30 at-bats. A little strategic move there by the Pioneers to put Esparza there with a hot bat at the bottom of the order. And that one's hit hard. Schrader again, he gathers it over to first for a 1-2-3 inning for Eaglet.
Three strikes and an out. Now we had the first two innings with a lot of action, and the next two, there's not even a home scored.
Yeah, that's right, partner. The fourth, that was our first 1-2-3 inning at the top of the fourth and the bottom of the fourth. We didn't have any 1-2-3 innings before mm-hmm. that.
Definitely. Now it seems like the defense is picking up on both ends.
Yes, it does. It does. It looks like the pitchers are kind of getting into their groove a little bit. You know, Brodsky, even though he's given up six runs, still hasn't thrown a ton of pitches. So, you know, here he comes out for the fifth inning again. And already here in the fourth inning, the Gators already have the same amount of runs they scored in the whole game. Last game was six.
Now batting, the right fielder, number 26, Daniel Santos.
And with over half the game to go, it's safe to say they might eclipse that six-run total from their last game.
Now I bet. For the Gators, number 26, Daniel Santos. No swing, straight down the middle, strike one.
And And that one's hit into the outfield by Santos, and it falls down.
Was that a homer?
Oh, that one's over the fence for Santos as he jogs around the bases. That's his first home run of the year.
First of the inning, right? And first home run.
Great hit in the swing, Santos.
Yeah, and that one just squeezed over the outfield fence. Fooled us. Thought it might have landed in the field of play, but no, that one gets over.
Gators lead 7-2.
Four bagger for Santos as he gets greeted by his teammates in the dugout.
At bat for the Gators, number 23, Nick Upstill.
Yeah, 8 games for the Gators this year. That's only their 6th home run, so, you know.
However they can get it.
Yeah, you know, not a common occurrence, but it's also, you know, definitely big pick-me-up for the Gators here, really separating themselves in the game. That one's right down the first baseline, and he's out at first base. Up still hustling down the line hard there. Just beat on the throw at first. Yeah, and with that home run, Santos now just the 3rd player on the Gators to go long this year.
And with 8 games with a 7-1 record, interesting enough.
And that's a strike there from Brodsky. And with 7 runs given up so far in the game, still nobody warming up in the bullpen for the Pioneers. Kind of surprising to see. And that one's high from Brodsky.
Yeah, so this would be the instance where they make that change because he's given up 7.
Yeah, you'd think you might start to see some movement on the left field line down there in the bullpen, but you don't see anybody warming up yet. And the off-speed pitch is low there. Up still lays off. Excuse me, Clark lays off. Pardon me. And Clark lays off again. Just
another low
pitch. Just about in the same spot, yeah. And Clark with a patient approach. Waits for the pitch from Brodsky. He delivers. And that one's hit hard on the ground. Through the hole in the left side of the infield for a single. And
great hit.
The Gators keep it going on offense here.
Back at the plate, Cody Gardner. Last at bat, didn't he have not an RBI, but he did get a single.
Yes, I believe you're right, partner.
Right down the middle, strike.
Gardner takes that one for a strike. And Gardner swings and a miss for strike 3. And that's a strikeout there for the Pioneers pitcher.
That's 2 outs.
Yep, that's 2 outs quickly there for the Gators.
Just 1 run allowed, but after that, nothing else, huh? At bat for the Gators, number 7, Gavin Hermitas.
And here's Heimovitz stepping into the box.
Yeah.
Brodsky throws one in for a strike. And that one's chopped to the second baseman of the Pioneers, thrown over to first for the third out of the inning. And that's the halfway point in today's game as we finish off. Or no, excuse me. That's the end of the bottom of the fourth. So here we go to the top of the fifth as we approach the halfway point in this game.
Other than that home run, it's quick, huh? That was not too much action.
And Eaglet's coming on here for the fifth inning. After that bumpy first couple of innings, Eaglet's really settled in here. As we kind of alluded to earlier, he seems to be a common occurrence for him to have his pitches be more effective as the game works its way into the later innings. And sure enough, now we see some relief pitchers for the Pioneers starting to warm themselves up down the right or left field line there. We might have seen the last of Brodsky today. And as Eaglet gets ready to start the fifth here, Gators up 7-2. 8 hits to the Pioneers, 4. And San Francisco State has one error themselves, 2-2 for Cal State East Bay. And Essex Brown Jr. coming up to bat for his third plate appearance of the day to lead off the fifth inning. And he fouls that one off.
He slips there, too.
Yeah, off balance. Falls to his tuchus there.
Looks, hobbles getting up, but.
That one, he might have fouled that one off his foot there. It's possible. So, yeah, it seems like he's trying to walk it off a little bit. And that one's a little high there for Eaglet, taken by Brown Jr. Ooh, that off-speed pitch got away from Eaglet a little bit there. It was by the ear of Brown Jr.
In that scenario, do you take that hit and
no,
walk?
Absolutely not. Maybe if it was a few inches lower, but yeah. Oh, and that one, that one did hit him. Just tipped his elbow there. It's an easy walk to the base there for Brown Jr. Very minimal contact on the hit by pitch there. And incredibly, Brown leads the Pioneers. That is the seventh time he's been hit by a pitch this year. In only 8 games for Cal State East Bay. And he almost got hit on the pitch before that, too. It's almost like maybe the ball just has a magnet for Brown Jr. this season.
Great pitch.
Yeah,
that strike.
One's fastball in there for strike one to Manny Garcia. He looked at that one go by. And Brown Jr. takes his lead off first. Eaglet from the stretch. Doesn't look at him. Oh, he throws over. Yes, as the sun begins to set here at Maloney Field, the temperature is dropping a little bit.
Definitely so. It looks great, but feels cold.
Yeah, the sun is shining, but can't feel it very much here in the announcer's booth.
Maybe for an athlete playing.
And Eaglet checks on the runner there at first. He dives back in safely. Eaglet's been making the Pioneers runners get their jerseys dirty today, diving back in on pickoff attempts. And Manny Garcia lines that one foul. Garcia, 8 hits and 32 at-bats coming into the game. As he waits from the pitch from Eaglet. That one's low.
With one runner at-bat, let's see if Eaglet can get this, get him out.
And Eaglet checks on the runner at first again for the third time in this at bat. A good scoop there from Gardner to keep that one from getting past him. And that one's chopped to first base to Gardner.
Nope.
And just foul, says the umpire.
And is he out? Because oh no,
it looks like his foot's still bothering him there from when he fouled it off.
SF Gators coach goes down and talks to the ref, discussing something.
Yeah, Gators head coach Schifani there asking the umpire about that foul call there. And now the umpires are gathering on the first baseline here to discuss the play. And the call stays the same. The runner remains at first base. And Garcia waits at the plate from Eaglet to deliver, and he checks on him again at first base. Fourth pickoff attempt in the at-bat.
They've really been picking at first base.
Well, you know, partner, I just realized something. Essex Brown Jr. is 10 for 10 in stolen base attempts this year.
So
he, by far and away, leads both teams in stolen bases. And that time...
Oh, there's confusion on the field. Essex Brown Jr. thought that was a fourth ball.
Yes, Essex Brown Jr. thought the batter had walked, but he did not.
And then tries to run back at first, but then they knock him out. Seems to be confusion on their end, but now number 7 for the Cal State East Bay. Number 9 is at bat. That is Manny Garcia.
Yeah, Essex Brown Jr., as we were saying, he thought that was ball 4, started to jog to second base, and it was only ball 3, so he was picked off at first for the second out of the inning.
Now batting the third baseman, number 5, Luke Kovitsky.
Yeah, and as we were saying there, Eaglet was continuously trying to pick off Essex Brown Jr. at first there, and with 10 stolen bases in 10 attempts, it's safe to say that Eaglet was justified in his pickoff attempts there.
Yeah, they definitely had their scouting report on Essex Brown Jr.
And it worked out well too, because with all those pickoff attempts, it made Essex Brown Jr. lose count. Lose track of the count there. So
force him into error.
Yeah, Eaglet really playing chess out there on the mound. And the number 3 man, Luke Nowitzki, in the order comes up for the Pioneers. 10 hits and 35 at-bats so far for Cal State East Bay. And Eaglet again to first base with the pickoff attempt. Seems like he's had as many pickoff attempts as pitches today.
Definitely, they don't want to allow any more runs and just hold this lead as long as they can.
No, he doesn't want to give the Cal State East Bay runners any more of an extra lead than they already have. That is for sure.
It's also a strategic thing too by the pitcher, because now the runners are not playing as off as on bases now, and they're going to stick to home and not even try to steal.
Yeah, he's definitely Eaglet's definitely taken away any offensive momentum for the Pioneers.
One out and two balls.
And that one's fouled off there.
Number 9, Manny Garcia tried to steal one, but it was a foul ball, so he has to return to first base.
And Eaglet gets set. Pickoff attempt again. What else is new? It's a 2-2 count here to Nowitzki with one out in the top of the fifth inning.
See, he did try to steal in the last play. He did try to steal a plate, but it was foul, so. Ooh.
And that one a little outside for Eaglet, full count. And with the count full, something's got to give here for Eaglet. And the runner takes off.
Goes straight to second. Shortstop catches it. They definitely get first out, but runner out.
Second baseman Schrader throws over to first for out number 2. Garcia just a little too speedy down the line there to get him at second for the force, as he stands on second with two outs here. Luke Brown comes to the plate.
The second Luke.
Yes, Luke number 2, the cleanup hitter. Cal State East Bay, far and away the best average on their team this year at 353. And he looks at that one for ball one. Eaglet stares in at the catcher, gets the sign, and he delivers. That's a strike, 1-1 count. And, you know, it seems almost like today that Eaglet in the beginning of innings out of the windup is having a little bit of trouble. Once he goes into the stretch with runners on base, he really bears down. That one bobbled by Gardner at first. Did they get him? No, says the pitcher was off the bag when he got the ball.
Number 20,
Gardner misplayed that one on the bounce. He tried to shovel it over there. It was in time, but the pitcher was not able to get his foot on the bag.
Definitely a good effort, but very close call. Great call by the ref.
Yeah, it's a tough play for a pitcher there. You know, not normally.
Do you have to run from the?
Yeah, not normally in the play defensively like that, and you know, trying to catch the ball while running, and also make sure you tag the base. It's a lot of moving parts.
Oh, and the refs looked at the SF State bench and said, gives them a warning for no commentary.
Yeah, Gators players chirping a little bit in the dugout there, and. Umpire making sure
they keep
things a little calm down. That's a dugout warning there for San Francisco State.
The Gators are excited with the 7-2 lead.
Yeah, you can't blame the Gators for having the energy high here. Maybe just dial it back a little bit.
And that one's fouled off again. Catcher underneath it, but third baseman Heimovitz comes in. Third out of the inning.
the SF State Gators didn't give up no runs, but still had some questionable calls there. So questionable plays, at least. And now they're at turn to bat.
Yeah, and the Gators coach there, letting Gardner know what he thought about his fielding. But, you know, that's you know, Gardner's set a very high standard for himself this season. Mm-hmm. He's been easily the most productive player on the Gators. So, you know, once you build yourself up to that level of play, your coaches expect you to keep it. So, not a bad thing for Gardner.
Of course. It's all coaching.
And A.J. Schrader is going to be leading it off here for the Gators.
We saw some batters, some pitchers warming up for the Pioneers, but they still look to have Ethan Brodsky still at pitch.
It's good observation there, partner. Seems like they're really trying to empty the tank for Brodsky here. It's possible that maybe for Cal State East Bay, their last series, they might have had a lot of innings thrown by the pitcher, so perhaps trying to get the most out of the guys they have. That one's fouled off by Schrader, out of play behind the visitor's dugout.
A swing and a hit in the middle of third and second, and a catch by Cal State East Bay outfielder. Number nine for the SF State Gators, Matt Sugden.
Yeah, and the Gators catcher made the EBAL first team all league as a catcher when he was a senior in high school. And he grounds out to the third baseman to start off the inning for San Francisco State.
Quick two outs to start this inning.
Yes, indeed. Quite a fast two outs.
At bat for the Gators, number six, Caleb Chance. Pioneers are looking to close this one inning out. Ooh. Great pitch. That was a strike.
Yeah, some willpower shown by Brodsky here to come back like this in the fifth after the troubles he had. And he ends the inning with a strikeout.
The ref calls it out.
Yeah, that was a quick one for the Gators there. Yeah, that ball was in the dirt on strike three, but it bounced up and hit the Gators player in the shin, so he is out.
And that's the end of the fifth inning. Now they're going to the top of the sixth. This is the halfway mark, right? Stagnant so far in the last two innings, but still Gators with the lead, 7-2.
Yeah, now both teams with two errors. Eaglet been able to hold the Pioneers scoreless for three straight innings. See if he can keep it up here.
as the game goes on, the weather gets chillier and chillier. It is definitely cold.
Yeah, it's you know, we already kind of mentioned it, but it is interesting. You know, if you can actually just see from the feed watching right now, it probably looks like it's about, you know, 60 degrees out, but no, it's a lot closer to 40 degrees.
Yeah, that's San Francisco weather for you.
Yeah, you're not kidding, partner.
Now I bet for the Pioneers.
And Eaglet starts off the sixth here with an off-speed pitch. Eaglet again. That one again in there for strike two. Two straight off-speed pitches to start off the sixth inning.
Swing and a hit, but is out by Cody Gardner at first.
Now batting the designated hitter, number 10, Jacob Kilavisky.
Number 10 for the Cal State Pioneers, Jacob Kilavisky.
And Eaglet almost to his average so far for innings pitched this year. In two appearances, he has 11.2 innings pitched, so just about six per game and two away from six here today. And that one in there for a strike. Eaglet seems to have his command really working for him right now. He delivers again. That one's fouled off. Four straight strikes to start the sixth inning for Eaglet. And Klonowski's still looking for his first hit of the season. And the fastball is in a good spot, but a little high there from Eaglet, says the umpire. Klonowski waits for the pitch from Eaglet, and that one's fouled off at the San Francisco State dugout. And swing and a miss in the dirt, and that one's thrown to first for out number two. Another strikeout for Eaglet.
Eaglet so far has been playing a great game. It has the balance of everything and not allowing any runs and not too many scores, too.
Now batting the catcher, number 15, Jacob Fraze.
Jacob Fraze at bat for the Pioneers.
A little outside from Eaglet. Eaglet rears back and called a ball by the umpire. Gators pitcher looking for another 1-2-3 inning. That one's grounded hard to the shortstop, corralled over to first, and he does. Another 1-2-3 inning for Eaglet.
The defense by the Gators has been superb so far, not allowing any runs in the past.
No, not since the second inning.
Not since the second inning.
And the score still sits at 7-2 here as we make our way into the bottom of the sixth inning. The leadoff hitter for the Gators, Sammy Gonzalez is going to be starting things off here for San Francisco State. And seems like Gonzalez's running catch in deep center field earlier in the game is really looming large right now. That could have broken things open for the Pioneers a little bit, but Gonzalez was there and ready. Yeah, and that post-college goal we talked about earlier with the fireworks shopper, Sammy Gonzalez, he even knows what he wants to call it. He wants to call it POW, which stands for Powerful Obnoxious Wonders.
Well, we'll hope to see, let's see if he displays that type of power right here, I bet.
Yeah, you said it. Like to see some fireworks at the plate here.
You still find it interesting that they haven't changed pitchers yet?
I do. Yeah, definitely not the Gators, because Eaglet's really been finding his stride and building momentum as we've been moving along. But, I mean, you know, Brodsky's definitely not having as much trouble as he had early on either. But, yeah, still surprised to see him coming out here in the bottom of the sixth. We'll see if it was a smart decision or not from the Cal State East Bay coaching staff.
Maybe the question is now, do they have any other reliable pitchers?
Yeah, well, they do. They have someone warming up down there, but you're right. You know, it might be lack of faith in their relief staff.
Foul ball by the Gators.
But, you know, the Pioneers, they do have a winning record so far this year. They're 6-4, so you would think that, you know, the guys throwing out of the bullpen for them have to have been at least somewhat successful this year.
A high throw and a ball.
Yeah, that one very high to Gonzalez. Easy for him to lay off.
Another foul ball by the Gators.
Yep, that one foul out of play into the bullpen. And two strikes and one ball here to Gonzalez. Sprotsky delivers, and that one's hit hard into the outfield. Outfielder's going back, and that one falls in front. It stops on the warning track, and Gonzalez is zooming around the bases.
Going all the way to third base.
Into third base, standing up is Gonzalez. And he's
displaying that power, huh?
Yes, yes indeed. Definitely, definitely powerful and definitely obnoxious to Cal State East Bay.
Now at bat for the Gators, number 26, Daniel Santos. And the SF State's pin better be careful. They did get a warning call about a commentary. Another hit that leads to base out at home at first.
Yeah, that was a hard hit ball there, but stopped by the Cal State East Bay defense.
At bat for the Gators, Nick Upstill, sophomore. Arts it off with a strike. Oh no, a ball.
And then Upstill waits for the pitch from Brodsky.
Oh,
and
no pitch.
Yeah, off speed in the dirt there. Swing and a miss.
Find a way here, babe.
And that one's fouled off by Upstill, softly down the first baseline.
Very slow game so far now. Let's see if they can pick up the pace with a player at third. High pitch by Brodsky, another ball.
And a 1-2 count here to Upstill. And that one's high. Two balls, two strikes.
A high hit from the Gators, but it leads into a catch. A toss over. We don't score.
Yeah, Sammy Gonzalez thought about tagging up there on the fly ball to left field, but thought better of it.
Justin Clark next to bat for the Gators. Ethan Brodsky is able to have two outs, looking to get his third to hopefully have the Pioneers next at bat. And
that one in for a strike from Brodsky as he starts out the bottom of the sixth here.
That was a strike.
And Brawley gets ready with the pitch. Here it comes. And third baseman has him out at first.
And there's that third out that we're looking for. Now next at bat is the Pioneers.
Yes, into the top of the seventh inning we go here. We'll see if Eaglet comes out to the mound again. No, that's it for Eaglet.
Gators with a commanding lead of 7-2, going into the sixth.
Yes, in the
seventh.
And going into the seventh, the first pitching change of the afternoon for either team, Justice Naragi is going to be coming on in relief for San Francisco State.
Now, overall, the performance for Jordan Eaglet, how do you feel about it?
I thought it was a great pitching performance. I mean, you know, a quality start, less than three runs in six innings, so you can't ask for much more for that from Eaglet.
Now it looks like he's giving a rest.
Yeah, and Naragi is yet to give up an earned run so far this year with a 0-0-0 ERA. He's one of four pitchers on the Gators who are yet to give up an earned run this far into the season.
Batting for the Pioneers, number 14, Samuel Espresa.
Yeah, Naragi's one of only two Gators pitchers with two wins on the year so far. And he starts off his day with a fastball down the middle. And that one fired in there for strike two from Naragi.
Justin Naragi is a junior out of Modesto, California, and gets the first two strikes. Oh.
That one bobbled a little bit by the second baseman, but still there in plenty of time to get the runner at first, out number one of the inning.
See, the margin for error for those types of plays is so thin because the how quick they're about to touch the mat and the ball touching their gloves is just so spontaneous or instant, like at the same time. It's ridiculous.
Yeah, game of inches and seconds, that's for sure. And Essex Brown Jr. coming to the bat again. And last time he was picked off at first.
Looking to redeem himself from that error.
Yeah, and Naragi and the Gators are going to try their best to keep him off base because obviously a big threat to steal a bag at any given time.
And Essex Jr. fouls that one off.
Going into the Essex State side.
And that one was hauled in by San Francisco State for out number two in the inning. Manny Garcia coming up here. And the Gators now has been over four innings without surrendering a run, and surrendered very few hits in the last three innings also.
At bat for the Pioneers, number nine, Manny Garcia. Just is looking to get his third strikeout. See, and that swing they do with the that fake swing, what is that considered? Is that an out? Is that a strike? Or is that a ball?
That was a check swing, but as long as the bat doesn't cross the plate, it doesn't count as a swing. And that is another strike. Umpire thought it was strike three, but apparently it wasn't. So it's strike two. He realized his mistake pretty quickly there. Oh,
foul ball.
That one fouled into his own dugout there. By Garcia. Seems to be like everyone's out of the way. And Garcia grounds that one to Gardner, and this time Gardner is able to play that one cleanly for another 1-2-3 inning for the Gators.
Great start for Justice Naragi in his first at-bat, or first pitching.
Yeah, that's now almost four innings pitched on the year for Naragi, and still no runs given up. It'll be interesting to see if he comes out again for the eighth. And now we get ready to stretch here in the seventh inning stretch.
For Cal State East Bay, they do make a sub at switch. Number 37 comes in for pitching. That is Max Gonzalez, a junior out of Ohlone College. He's looking to come in and see if they can hold the Gators to no runs, like they have been doing so far for the past two, three innings.
Yeah, and so far this year, Gonzalez has been struggling a little bit on the mound. His ERA is over 5 in just about 3 innings pitched, so Gators might try to tack on to their lead here a little bit.
With that pitching, why do you think the Pioneers make that switch?
Well, at this point, with a 5-run deficit this late into the game, I think the Pioneers have probably just about even though it's a 5-run deficit, they can still come back, but they've probably just about conceded this game and have thought that, you know, instead of bringing in one of their more skilled pitchers, might as well save him for a closer game.
Mm-hmm. And give him some experience at mound. Cody Gardner is back at bat for the Gators.
And Gardner takes the off-speed pitch from Gonzalez low to start the bottom of the 7th inning. And Gardner lost that one high. It'll be an easy play for the shortstop. And that's one out in the inning for the Gators.
Gavin Himovich back at bat for the Gators, number 7.
Already 2 big hits this afternoon for Himovich. Takes that off speed for a strike looking.
Low pitch and a ball. By the Pioneers.
Patience shown by the Gators third baseman here. And that's another ball. 2 balls, 1 strike to Himovich here. And fouled off behind the catcher from Himovich. 2 strikes, 2 balls. And that off speed waited on there by Himovich, but he's out at first. 2nd out of the inning.
Number 5 for the San Francisco Gators, A.J. Schrader, back on the mound. Looking to add some runs to this inning because they have 2 outs.
Schrader gets ready for the pitch. That one's high, ball 1.
Low pitch, another ball by the Pioneers.
Here comes the pitch from Gonzalez. It's hit hard, but foul. Pass first base. swinging and a miss from Schrader there. Big whiff coming up empty for number five there. See if he can protect the plate with two strikes. And he lays off the off speed there and draws a walk for the Gators. Schrader down to first base. And Matt Sugden, the Gators' man behind the plate, comes up here trying to keep the ball rolling for the Gators, maybe extend that lead a little bit here in the seventh. And with the five-run lead here in the bottom of the seventh, the Gators players are all smiles in the dugout.
They feel the wind coming.
Yes, yes. And Sugden digs in for the pitch here from Gonzalez. And he hits that one hard up the middle. Gets through, and Schrader stops at second base. Runners on first and second here with two outs. A little two-out rally here from San Francisco State. Number nine man, Caleb Chance, coming up.
Caleb Chance, the sophomore out of De La Salle. See what he does on the at-bat.
Oh. And that one's off Gonzalez's glove and through to the outfield. Schrader turns around third and crosses home plate for the Gators' eighth run of the game.
Caleb Chance was able to get that over the pitcher and through first and second.
Yeah, that one chopped right over the pitcher's glove, and when it hit the glove there, it knocked the ball off line, so the second baseman was out of position there. And now runners remain at first and second base with two outs here for the Gators, but another run on the board in the top of the lineup coming up with Sammy Gonzalez here. And the breaking ball in there for a strike at the bottom of the zone. And Gonzalez from the stretch gets ready to deliver, looks at the runner at second. And that one's hit hard again on the ground and into the outfield again. And rounding third is Sugden, and he is home. That's nine runs for the Gators.
Now we have a runner at one, at first and third. Great hit by number 10 for the Gators, Sammy Gonzalez. Now the Gators look like they're picking up a little pace towards the end of the innings.
Yes, it seems like taking advantage of the struggles Gonzalez has had so far this year, they continue to be plaguing him. Hasn't had a very easy go of it on the mound so far, and the Gators highlighting that.
Daniel Santos at bat for the Gators.
That one high, but called a strike by home plate umpire Sid Aguilar. Gonzalez gets ready with the pitch. And
we have.
And Caleb Chance caught in a rundown between first and second. Run scores before he gets out. So that is run number 10 for the Gators. Very strategic play there on the bases.
While they were focused, the runner on first going to second, the third baseman was able to go home and score.
Yeah, and since that runner crossed the plate before the runner between first and second was tagged out, that's the 10th run there for the Gators.
Now putting that lead up to 10-2, 8-point lead going at the second.
Or in the seventh?
Going into the eighth inning.
Yeah, top of the eighth here coming up, partner. And after that great inning, the last time out, Naragi is back out there on the mound again for the second straight inning.
The Pioneers were able to hold the Gators to no runs in the last two innings, but Gators were able to break through that and score three in the seventh. Great.
Yeah, four out of the Gators' seven innings so far, they've been able to put runs on the boards. Pretty impressive. And on the flip side, now five innings straight, holding the Pioneers scoreless after giving up one run each in the first two innings.
Gators look to clamp down on defense, or clamping down on defense when the game goes on. Looking to close this game out.
Yeah, San Francisco State now in double digits in hits and runs with 12 and 10 respectively.
Great game overall by the Gators, honestly.
Now batting, third baseman number 5, Luke Nowitzki.
Back at bat for the Pioneers, number 5, Luke Nowitzki.
Nowitzki takes that pitch low and away for ball number 1.
Another ball thrown by the Gators.
And that one fired in there for a strike from Naragi. Another one low and outside there.
The last three or four of them have been low. And that's four balls.
Nowitzki draws a walk there on a full count. Naragi not able to put him away. Leadoff man on for Cal State East Bay here in the eighth. Right fielder number 8, Luke Brown, stepping into the box as Naragi checks at first base on Nowitzki. Ball gets away from him, but runner stays at first. And Naragi digs in on the mound from the stretch here with a runner on first. Little high there, taken for ball 2. Delivers, and that's another strike.
Oh,
is that a full count?
2-2, 2-ball, 2 strikes.
Naragi looking for the strikeout here, and he gets it looking. Sits down Brown.
Great pitch by Justin Naragi. Matthew Mahoney for the Pioneers, first baseman, is at bat.
And that one's popped up into shallow right field.
With the sound, it sounds like it went, so they caught it and it was out. From this angle, we can't really tell. Wow.
Oh, a great diving catch in foul territory.
We got that lay on replay, but yeah, that was a great diving catch by the Gators.
Daniel Santos with a home run already today. Now he's showing it with the glove in the field. Two outs for the Pioneers here.
High pitch by Gators. Looks like it's a ball.
Naragi delivers. And that one's fouled off. Cole Anderson here at the plate against Naragi. Two outs in the inning.
A foul ball.
And the tennis players in the tennis court were running for their lives there as they did not know where the ball was going to land.
Yeah, Jacob Kalinske hit a foul ball going out of the play and into the tennis courts behind us. Another swing, fouling out, not too far away.
A few long foul balls from Cole Anderson here in the eighth. Naragi trying to get out of it here in the eighth. And keep the Gators lead at eight. And that one's driven into the outfield, but right at Sammy Gonzalez in center field, who was in great position to make that catch.
That's the third out and end of the inning.
Yeah, here we go into the bottom of the eighth inning. Could very well be the Gators' last time at the plate here. And as the sun is starting to begin to set at Maloney Field, it seems like the hopes of the Pioneers are also beginning to set.
Yes, indeed. Their hopes and dreams of winning this game is fading, and I think they realize that. Now it's just closing this out for the Gators.
Yes, and score 10-2 here as we enter the bottom of the eighth with 12 hits for the Gators, only 4 for the Pioneers. They've been held scoreless since the fourth inning. They've been held hitless and scoreless since the fourth inning. Both teams cleaning things up after a couple early errors. Now play in the field has been pretty solid since then.
What do you think of the pitching from Justin Naragi?
Oh, it was great. It's now 5 innings this year thrown from Naragi with 0 earned runs. So obviously can't ask for any more than that. He's been spotless and continues on his hot streak to start the year. It'll be interesting to see when, if ever, he does give up an earned run.
Yeah. Maybe they look to him to close more games now, or maybe even a bigger role.
Yeah, it seems like right now his role, like in the in between innings, setting up the closer, has been working out. But it seems like it remains to be seen. But yeah, Naragi along with a couple other relievers.
starters for the Gators have been really performing well. Mickey Radonovich and Mario Vargas also both have zero earned runs given up this year.
Great pitching by the Gators. Now at bat by the number 26, Daniel Santos.
Yeah, Santos definitely the star of the game here for the Gators. Big home run and big catch in right field, and also Heimovitz with a few big hits.
He hits it again deep into center field, but Pioneers get under it, and it's out.
That one's hauled in by Cal State East Bay center fielder Essex Brown Jr.
Number 23 for the Gators, Nick Upstill, is on the mound, ready to hit. Swinging a hit straight in and between center field and left field.
Yeah, that one hit on a line by Upstill and T. Brown's first, but stays there for a single to lead off the bottom of the eighth inning. And we're going to have our first pinch hitter of the afternoon here for the Gators as Christian Smith is coming up to the plate here in place of Justin Clark.
Now, why would the Gators do this type of move or make this move?
Just giving somebody else an extra chance who maybe doesn't get to play that much with a big lead here late in the game. Get him some extra playing time, you know, see
him at bat, yeah. See what he has to offer.
Exactly.
And maybe even give him more experience.
Yes, indeed, partner.
Starts off with a strike.
Yeah, and it's already hard enough to come off the bench, you know, and this late in the game, after you've been sitting, you mm-hmm. know, and seeing live pitches. But you know, when the temperature is as cold as it is, it makes it even harder to come off the bench and immediately try to contribute. Upstill waits between first and second, and that one does drop in. So he advances to second. Christian Smith with a single in his pinch hitting at bat there.
Now at bat for the Gators, number 20, Cody Garner.
And that one very low, bounced in the dirt in front of home plate. Garner does not tempted by that one. Gonzalez from the stretch looks at the runner on second, gets ready to deliver. Here's the pitch.
Oh, right down the middle.
Taken by Gardner, close pitch, but a good eye with a ball.
Oh, a ball. Interesting. Oh, I looked right down the middle of my eyes.
That's right, partner. Tricked you. Yeah, that was a really close pitch. Wow. Could have gone either way.
Curved out. That's ridiculous. Oh, runner at second is going to third. Missed catch by the catcher.
And up still safely in there with a stolen base. And Smith advances two as the ball was in the dirt there. Catcher unable to get it in a timely manner. Both runners in standing up, advancing. Now it's two in scoring position for Gardner, Gators leading RBI man on the season. See if he can add to his total here. Takes that one for a strike. You're good. You go.
And with one out here, it's a hitter's count to Gardner, 3-1. Pitch comes, he takes it a little inside, but that one's called a strike by the home plate umpire. Full count now. Gardner's going to have to protect the plate. Gonzalez ready. Gardner hits that one on the ground, and it's hauled in by the shortstop for the Pioneers.
Number 23 for the Gators, Nick Upstill, is able to get a run, but second placeman decides to stay strategically because the ball was very close.
Yeah, yes. Didn't want to get the third out of the inning there, and Gardner now with another RBI to add on to his team-leading total there.
Now just a runner at second. Gavin Hemovic, number 7 at bat. A big swing, but it looks to be a foul ball.
Heimovitz ready for the pitch, seeing if he can't get his third big hit of the afternoon here. Pad the lead even more. And he does. Ooh. That one is through. Three hits on the afternoon for Heimovitz. A great game. And now it's going to be runners on the corners here. Now
batting, the second baseman, number 5. Seems like the Gators are still applying pressure even this late into the game with this big lead.
Yeah, definitely not letting up here.
At bat for the Gators, number 5, AJ Schrader. A high pitch by the Pioneers.
Gonzalez delivers, and that one's high again.
Two ball.
Runners at first and third for Schrader at the plate. Gonzalez in the stretch. He throws. That one's foul, tipped by Schrader and dropped by the catcher. Lives to see another pitch.
That was very close to just, it looked like it was an out, but I guess he tips it with his bat at the end.
Gonzalez again with the pitch. And that one line foul over the Pioneers dugout.
Two count. The low ball.
Full count here to Schrader with two outs, bottom of the eighth. He digs in the box and he grounds that one. Second baseman has it and got him at first to end the eighth inning. And, you know, assuming the Gators do not give up 9 runs this inning, this will be the final half inning here.
Just wanted to confirm, yes, at the end of that play, number 17 for the Gators, Christian Smith, was able to get the run, make it an 8-point lead, 11-2. Oh, 9-point lead. Sorry about that. Total of 15 runs for the Gators. Or 15 hits. Sorry there, guys. I'm done.
Now batting the designated hitter, number 10, Jacob Linovisky.
Just taking pictures for the class.
Go, JJ!
All right.
And Aragi coming on for his third inning of work and relief after two very clean innings thrown.
Gators looking to close this game. Low pitch.
And Aragi will have the 7-8-9 hitters for the Pioneers, the bottom of the order, see if he can handle them. Yeah, and as we mentioned earlier, all time, the Gators are 25-25 against the Pioneers, so this game would give the Gators an edge in the all-time series. And Cody Gardner makes a great play on a line drive over to him at first base. After the error early in the game, that must feel good for Gardner.
For Cal State East Bay, hitting number 16. Connor McWard.
And that one bounced to Gardner at first. He makes another good play. Two outs in the inning. One to go here for the Gators to get win number 8 on the season.
8-1. Doesn't that sound great for a baseball team starting out?
That's great for San Francisco State. And, they're with the one more out here, they will take the all-time series lead against the Pioneers, which would be great. And they've also lost 2 straight against Cal State East Bay. So it would be nice to get nice to get that streak over with, and it looks like they might have. And yes,
out 3.
He is out at first, and that is it. The Gators take this one by a score of 11-2. That is their 7th win straight, and they move to 8-1 on the year. Their next game will be here tomorrow afternoon at 12 o'clock as they take on the Pioneers again in a doubleheader. And if weather permits on Sunday, they will play again against the Pioneers. And it's been a great day here with you. I'm Joe Perello here with my partner,
AJ.
And this broadcast has been brought to you by the BECA program, available on the BECA YouTube channel for San Francisco State. And we'll see you again soon, Gator fans. Have a good one.
Gator out.